Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6 foot six, weighing 245, kind of broad at the shoulder, narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't say much, kind of quiet and shy. And if he spoke at all, he just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen, and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land, Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked and men started crying. Miners were praying and hearts beat fast. Everybody thought that they'd breathe their last, said John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant. Man that the miners knew well grabbed a sagging timber, gave out with a groan, and like a giant oak tree just stood there alone, Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
And with all his strength he gave a mighty shove, then a miner yelled out, "There's a light up above," and 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. Now there's only one left down there to save, Big John. With Jackson timbers they started back down, and then came that grumble way down in the ground, and the smoke and gas belched out of that mine. Everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Now they never reopened that worthless pit. They just placed a marble stand in front of it. These few words are written on that stand: at the bottom of this mine lies one hell of a man, Big John.
Big John.